PI BatchView Quick Search function allows you to search your batch information without having to go into any of your client tools. So if you just want to see what's running or what ran with certain parameters, you can do it very quickly without having to have a client tool loaded and figure out how to create a display or create a report. It's a very easy tool to use. You have some basic search criteria. Their results are shown in the lower area. They are expandable. And there's even an advanced search button that you can use to add various parameters. The first section is the attribute section, where you have by default batch ID, product, or unit name. But you can search any of the labels that you have on your batches. So for PI batch, you can search not only batch ID, but for product or recipe. Remember that we added those fields. For a unit batch, you can search not only ID, product, or recipe or procedure, but you could also search by unit name or heading, and you could even go to the sub-batch level and search by name or heading. So there's a lot of different ways that you can search, and they're all accessed through these drop-down boxes. There's an advanced tab if you want to combine criteria. In the earlier attribute section, you could only search for either unit batches or batches or some sub-batch information, but you couldn't combine them. In the advanced search, you can combine batch, unit batch, and sub-batch criteria, as well as adding filters to your searches. So there's a lot of different tools that you can use. One of the nice things about the batch function, the quick search, is that you can anchor batches. There's a column here for anchoring batches. This will anchor that result, and then any future searches that you have will include that result, even if that result doesn't fall into the criteria. So if you have a golden batch or a batch you're comparing other things to, you can anchor it and then continue to do other searches, and that batch will appear, that line item will appear in your future searches. So you can see here in the example, we've got a batch from unit 1, but we anchored that and then searched for unit 2, and we brought up more results, but the unit 1 still appeared in the search. And finally, you can set up your quick search options to show any columns or any type of data you want. So if you don't like showing batch ID, product, unit name, start time, end time, and duration, you can add other columns. You can add data columns. So the quick search tool is very, very customizable. You could even select the time zone that you're using, whether you're using server time zone or client time zone, if you happen to be in a different time zone. Or you can use custom name sets. We'll talk about those a little bit later in the course. Let's take a look at using the BatchView Quick Search. I'm going to go to my Programs, PI System, and PI BatchView Quick Search. When the application opens, I'm going to notice that I have asterisks in most of my fields, so I include both running and completed batches, unit batches, on my server, and I'm looking back over the last 24 hours, or between one day and now. And if I click Search, I'm going to return quite a few results. I've got 272 unit batches that occurred on my server. And let's say I want to narrow that down. I want to use only the batches that ran in my digesters. So I'm going to put the phrase digester in the unit name field, and I'm going to search. And you can see that I have narrowed it down. I have 43 results. 43 unit batches ran in the last 24 hours on my digester unit. Let's say I want to find all these batches that ran for less than a certain period of time. So let's say shorter than 50 minutes, shorter than 50 m. I click search, and I can see that 26 of those results ran shorter than 50 minutes. Let's say I want to configure a different type of filter, and in this case I want to find out if one of my aliases, my temperature alias, was greater than a certain value for more than 20% of the time. So I want to find out maybe if I overcooked something. So I'm going to click on Edit, and you can see that you get the advanced search dialog box up running, and I'm going to add a filter, single quote temperature, the word temperature, the alias in single quotes, and then the condition, greater than 180. And I want to know if that occurred in any of these batches for greater than 20% of the duration of the particular unit batch. So I'll click search, and I can see here that I have 6 results. They were all in digester 2. And if I want to, I can go and investigate those batches and see what happened during that, because clearly the temperature was higher for longer in these batches than in the other batches.